possibly naked. I can say
one big old stinky fart can stink a whole room up. Did you know that? They can be pretty smelly sometimes.
With you coming out of the hot tub with Miss Pat, I remember there was
big old stinky fart. I don't really know where I feel like going. I got challenges to do, like, everywhere. I don't know. Let's just, I'm sick of that level. Sick of that level. I don't know. Maybe we'll go to Colorado.
And just try. Such a great group of people that were game for everything.
You eliminate including even when they every like target Donnell, with a headshot.
Still was, you know, yeah. And even like he wasn't like with Dion, with the, he still was.
So that's
like,
combine that with the
my blood pressure is 170 over 120. They think I'm having a stroke. Like whatever the fuck, I'm bleeding out of my face. Like he's still fucking stuck around.
Sniper
the
one.
Of the his blood pressure was high, wasn't that bad?
Maybe.
It was
like I don't know. I don't know if I'm ready for this yet. This map, I don't know it very well.
Did you know that that night I went to CVS and bought a
I still have fiber wire, drying.
Yeah,
let's go for the fiber wire and drying. And, then we'll do something else after that.
Blood pressure taken because he was spitting blood and all yeah. that. And I went up and I was like, hey, do you mind just, you know, give him a... And I honestly, in my head, something told me, I was like, I do feel a little, you know, like, I just want to check what it is
having
right
a
now.
Ringing in my ears.
And
just make it easy
exactly
and start as this guy,
but,
I think.
I texted it to my mom and my mom was like, go
or
to
this guy.
CVS immediately, get a blood pressure machine.
I think the bomber guy would be better.
And I went and I left set. That's why I wasn't there when you guys had the immediate wrap. Because I went and I got a blood pressure machine, I had to bring it down because it was really fucking high.
It was an intense moment in time.
It was an intense moment in time, but it also, yeah.
This is the same as this. As this. These are all the same. They're all fiber wire. By the way, you can just pick this. It doesn't really matter. It's the same thing.
I know. Jeff had good reviews.
Yeah.
We're all like, we gotta do this now before it's too late.
Yeah, yeah.
I feel like we.
So I was gonna try to kill somebody with fiber wire and drowning. But this gun helps with drowning, and not absolutely necessary, but it helps. So fiber wire and drowning. I really don't know where any of these places are. I picked this one just because it's the most recent unlock.
Well,
it's the red barn, I guess that's easy enough.
The number one email I get, because I read
so fiber wire and drowning.
I'd be totally up for it, and I'll tell you why I would be up for it.
I get so many emails.
I'd be up for it, I'll tell you why.
I don't know. I don't know what else to bring for sure.
Snoop Dogg. So, we shot the...
Bring a medic poison syringe, which does the same thing as this, but
it's
totally silent. You can do it from behind. Nobody's watching this, so maybe if I fail to drown one of them by using this, I can use this.
I would do a season two, and I think you know,
that's
things...
so crazy to me that like, Snoop Dogg watched the show.
Oh, I think
a lot of people watched.
A lot of people watched.
I'm
surprised how many people know this show.
And I think I know that it's.
I get so many emails saying that's the show that got that person through the pandemic.
Yeah.
That show got them through the pandemic.
Yeah. I mean, it was tough because there's no. I mean. Very candidly, the show comes
that's great.
Out
start with the guy
well.
Right behind me.
There's
that
no way to shoot any TV
can't
show
get off
for
of this.
17 months or next year.
Oh,
like
probably
10 months. So there's no. I mean, talking to Netflix, they're like, yeah, we're not going to do a season two because we're not shooting anything.
Yeah.
And then I was like, yeah.
So
I was like, that stinks. But then everyone starts getting other projects. You start doing other projects.
Get
and
away
then
from this
all
guy.
Of a sudden, when people are like, hey man, are you in to doing another season of the Cabin? And that's everyone asked me if I would do another season of the Cabin. And I, and for a while, I was like, well, I think it was good for me what it was. I think it was a cool, like, you know,
kill one by drowning, kill one by fiber wire.
And play it
later,
it.
Or I'll look at the challenges again after that, I guess.
That is Sean Rose, terrorist turned insurgent.
Yeah, I was trying to think about, we talked about doing season 2 on a boat or something.
Yeah, a boat, and then there was the road trip also.
Yeah,
and we got this guard right behind him, so I can't shoot him with the gun that makes him sick. People are gonna see me.
But then, you know, the pandemic kind of got away from us, and I think our opportunity to then transition, which would have happened, I think, naturally, is that first week where Ben, I remember Ben calling me, I was on the road, and then he was like, congratulations. When I first got massive hit.
Look for any intruders, okay?
Enjoy yourself tonight and celebrate your success. It was a great fucking call. That was a great call.
Possible I could get like a split second possibility to.
And very honest. And very honest. Yeah.
Hitting with this,
and I think that when they would have been like, let's do a season 2.
I haven't picked up my pen syringe yet. Shit.
And then all of a sudden, I think when.
I better go get
by
that.
By the time they can make television, they've already got a list of new things they want to do. But, you know, I think I'm still working with Netflix right now on a few different projects, and they're not...
That is Maya Parvati, Sri Lankan assassin turned pirate.
I'm a bomber dude, I should be able to go anywhere.
The number one thing is, if I would be into doing it, and I'd fucking definitely be into doing it.
Oh, it would be great.
It would be so much
especially
fun.
Now that we know what
now,
the hell
now,
we're
now
doing.
Now that we know,
I would just love to do it and not be so stressed out because we know what.
First episode, Kelly Coco and Miss Pat.
The redo.
So, I'm sorry, this is a restricted. That's good, so
we can go.
And there's my briefcase over there somewhere. Or is it up there?
Well, wrap Matthew out. He's got
to go. I have to go. I'm so sorry.
What do you got for the rest of your day?
I'm playing golf.
See?
Motherfucker.
I didn't realize it was going.
Sorry, I've gone down the rabbit hole.
Do something stupid like that.
It was the quarantine sport.
Oh, yeah.
It was the one thing you could do outside with, you know, a lot of business.
Yeah, I should just put it somewhere else.
Our daughters joined the high school golf team because of that. Because that was the sport they could play in the pandemic.
Oh, really?
They're both
so
playing golf in high school.
Oh, it's fucking awesome.
Speaking
of which, I got to shoot a golf promo. Gentlemen, I want to thank you.
I don't know. I'm going to try starting as this guy.
It was a fucking blast.
Let's see what that's like. That's a militia soldier. Maybe he's better than I think.
Representation of who I am to people that wouldn't know were my fans, and it was a great representation of all my friends, and I could not have done it without you.
I don't know. Let's try it, Hayshed.
And Todd. Am I saying the right name?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ! I'm like fucking buzzed. It was
Garner.
Yeah, Todd Garner. Jesus Christ.
I had fucking a quarter of that beer and forgot everyone's name.
And everyone in Netflix for being as generous as they were. It was the coolest fucking experience of my life. I'm glad we finally did this podcast. And
yeah, it's so nice to see you after all this time.
It's great. Right back at you, too. It was such a great experience to do it with someone that you love and respect and get to work out on. Same with Todd, same with you. That's what makes these things great.
Yeah,
let me see if I can actually get to my stuff this time. Probably not.
It's nice to do this just because it was really fun. But it was so fast.
There you go.
It was really more stressful than it seems.
I just don't know what it is.
We need 29 days, not 26.
Anytime it puts it someplace I'd have to go to the skies to get to.
Let's do 36.
Yeah, let's do 36.
Let's try to get my stuff out at the beginning.
Let's do it to Hawaii next time.
I can get it. I have to work just to get my stuff.
El Blunto.
This was delicious.
El Blunto. Take the rest of the joint with you for golf.
I am.
Yeah,
that
yeah.
one I am.
And I
Does
also.
Does Joey have these too?
I also want to say, thank you to Leanne Kreischer. Because you were.
I started
a,
demolishing.
It's not on the list as an executive producer, but you were a silent executive producer that got so much shit done. And without you, the one thing I want to say.
Just post. After when we got home.
I can't remember where any of these places are.
The one moment when my impression of the show lacks, I remember sitting in the room and Leanne was laughing hysterically on the couch. And I go, I walked out, what the fuck are you laughing at? She goes, The Cabin. And I went, what? She goes, this show is fucking hilarious. And I was like, you think? And she's like, Bobby Lee and Donnell are fucking hilarious. And I was like, what? She's like, Bert, all these episodes are great. And I was like, are you being serious? She's like, yeah. And I was like, and all of a sudden I was like, fuck, I can't wait till this comes out.
Yeah, honestly, Leanne, I feel the same way. Like, I've watched 6 months of these cuts and I couldn't tell if it was good, bad, or what was working or not.
Yeah,
and having you, like, really feel great about it was really important to me.
Thanks, guys. Yeah. I also enjoyed it. It was fun.
And also, you have a long list of credits. You were a gaffer, you were a cameraman, you were a talent wrangler, you were talent, you were an executive.
She did craft services with the ice cream showed up.
We did, yeah. Location.
Location. This was the room. This was a location in one of the
rooms. We built the wall to mimic the wall of the cabin that you would sit in front of.
I just threw that wall out. I just threw it out.
Crazy that we were able to make that work.
That was insane.
Great, but we made it work.
Try this guy first, I guess.
Crazy.
A testament to the three people in this room. Gentlemen, Leanne, thank you for a successful series. It was a fucking blast. Ben Cavey, if you're listening, let's do season two.
Season two, Ben.
Puerto Rico.
Thanks, man.
Awesome. Wait, hold on. One second. You gotta play the thing. Okay, hold on. This is, Leanne, did you ever see these? So just so you know, we tried to get celebrities to do our show. And so we shot this sizzle to send to celebrities. So we sent it to, 150 celebrities.
This is how we got Anthony.
This is how, by the way. It worked one time.
And Caitlin too, right?
I think Caitlin.
They all got it, I think.
Okay.
No, I have to look. I'll tell you, it's a brilliant idea. Now we need an A-lister.
Oh, wait.
Did they let me come to you?
Save it right here and then try this pin syringe. Oh, he turned around right at the wrong time. Shit. Oh, he was facing the other way.
Listen up.
I should put this on Instagram.
A highly volatile compound here.
My name's Bert Kreischer. I'm a stand-up comedian.
Nitroglycerin, or 1,2,3 tritriatoxy propane, is a pretty unstable liquid. Screw up, and it will take your arms pretty much. Luckily for you, the batch we have at the munitions depot is chemically desensitized.
Thank you, guys.
It's about as safe as regular explosives. Still, I need you to be careful with the mixture. Add a little at a time. If you need more, go to the munitions depot and get it.
Can you get this? I don't have my wallet.
I'm not really trying to do that much right now. I'm just trying to do it. I don't know. Let me come back to this guy. He's going through his motions right now.
I have to say, it's
a night's the night. Don't show up late. Don't get into the traffic jam. Get your tickets right now. YMH Live is going to be streaming live from Austin, Texas.
You see the moon?
Go to livestream.ymhstudios.com and get your tickets right now.
And Ellis the other day, he goes, I give you a kiss. Good night. Yeah, buddy.
Now
he
licked my eye.
No, really just I was like, ugh.
We only
he was like, I didn't want to kiss you.
No, when you man.
This person has a whole army around me.
Welcome to your mom's house.
That is Penelope Graves,
acclaimed anti-terror analyst.
This episode of Trump Tower is brought to you by Sotva.
I've got to focus.
Go to sotva.com.
Well, it's not easy with an entourage. Okay? Thank you.
Hey
there. I'm Penelope Graves, the new analyst.
What's up?
So I've got my first real meeting with Sean Rose. Anything you think I should know about him?
Okay.
Look great.
He can be a bit of a hard ass from time to time. But
building
all those bombs needs to get channeled out somehow. Right?
I suspect you can't be alone thinking that. How's his relationship with the others?
The boss picked him for a reason. That's good enough for me. Whether people like him or not isn't my concern. We're on a mission. As long as he doesn't get me killed, we're A-OK.
How are the waspas?
I'm so glad you asked there. You know, it's a lot of people don't realize this, that in Los Angeles, it is also hot. People are talking about how hot it is in Texas. But right. Los Angeles is hot. So.
It's here today for making you drink water.
So that goes for Los Angeles residents, too, you know.
You're kidding. Well, how hot is it, Tom?
Hi, I'm Penelope Graves. You look like you've been part of the crew for a while. Just standing here, wondering how you're finding it here.
It's also, but
Sean
it's
Rose, okay to work with?
Rose.
It's a dry heat.
You don't feel it that much.
I don't know.
It's different
I'm not sure
than
if I fully trust the man that engages
now,
in
the
that amount
Austin
of personal
lately
hygiene.
Has been that it's not as hot as it usually is in the summertime.
I'm down with not smelling
so
as much as the next guy, but it seems like he's really into washing his hands.
It is.
You know?
Is that the general feeling among the men in the camp?
It's hard not to respect the skill.
Yeah.
I wouldn't
you know
look to him for leadership, but as a bomb builder.
You're so mad at what you ate because it wasn't good, and now I want to do a takeover.
You
want to
do over? I know.
I'm gonna order second lunch. And
second lunch will do it, and that's not a do over. That's called more calories. But I've done that many times where you go fuck that meal.
He's second to none, as far as I'm
concerned. That's what I'm saying, like, I didn't like the taste as much as I thought I would. And now, it's all in my belly, but
hey, good to see you, man.
You know what you can do if you, like,
better taste.
If you want to feel
sure
about it? This is really have dessert for your second lunch.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Like, just go get, like, a pint of ice cream and be like, this is lunch now, bitch.
Yeah.
Like, revenge
and the person
lunch.
That you're really sticking it to.
Delay the cards like this. I don't know if this is a good time to do it, but...
Okay.
You can hold them back and then
so mad.
Sometimes
yeah, I'm so mad
go do
myself
stuff.
For eating
but
the shitty lunch, but I had no options.
Not really a good example because I didn't end up doing anything. But...
right?
No, you fist your own ass
to spite
and you come
your
in
face.
Your face.
Oh, yeah.
To come in your
wait for them to turn their backs. I can't remember.
You're not allowed to be here, sir.
Oh, I'm not even
right
allowed
now.
To be in there. That sucks.
Just how we like
I want to be right now somewhere in the world. Someone just came in at my face.
Well, probably... more than one.
Shoe from the side or something, maybe?
But there's somebody out there right now who loves to do that.
Hey, why don't you take your tits out?
It's their favorite.
I'm asking you.
Me?
Yeah.
You want me to take my tits out on this show?
I wanna laugh.
Yeah.
It's showing me your boobs. Do you really want to show the listeners my tits?
No, I was just, you know, I was just...
Oh, you're
yeah,
setting me up for
that. Yeah. I really don't think
that'll probably work. I got that guy over there.
The show.
Would you like me to show everybody my tits?
If I distract this guy here.
You know, it's your body.
I have methods.
What was that for?
So you do whatever you want. But I don't think...
I feel like
I
don't want
it.
No, you're right. Yeah,
what the?
I mean, it's YouTube also. So,
YouTube. Oh, we can't even show.
It's the end of your channel.
Yeah,
hey,
I know. Which should be the beginning of a channel.
Now, why would anybody do a show that you could do like that?
Yeah, I would make so much more money if I did the show topless. Are you kidding me? Wasn't
there
a website at the beginning
didn't do
of the
any
internet
good.
That was Naked News? It was called the Naked News.
Yeah, people Naked News was the thing, yeah.
It did really well.
For sure it did well.
Come on.
Yeah,
I've got a big fat nothing here. Over.
And like, chicks that are close to naked or fully naked does well. It'll always
yeah.
Be well.
That's so true. What about, remember when we had...
We should produce a podcast, by the way.
Naked.
No, we should produce a podcast just called Dumb Sluts. And...
There is one.
they're really dumb. Like, like struggle to put sentences together, but they're close to naked.
Oh, hi.
Every week, we're like, check out dumb sluts on YMH. And they're just like,
that's
a... I got my
have some respect.
Back.
Keep your distance.
Just
to see how it blows away.
I keep looking for an opportunity to get her alone for just a second.
I would do it with you, Tom. I fully endorse this. Where can we air it, though? Can we do it on YouTube? You know what it should
be? They can't
be,
like, fingering themselves, but they could be...
No, No, it's that simple. It's two chicks in bikinis.
Yeah.
It's not even,
probably can't even
it's
go in here,
right?
Enough with the monkey
business.
You are trespassing on
private
property.
Right now,
thank you.
So listen, I've been thinking maybe the usage is just wrong. Did you check?
I appreciate your enthusiasm.
And can I tell you why it's going to succeed? Because right now the zeitgeist is
too,
like, for instance, Victoria's Secret,
so
the angels
maybe there's
are not
wrong
hot
with the
anymore.
Delivery system?
They're women that are accomplished in the world,
guy.
Which is so dumb.
Again,
like, nobody wants to
I
see
also
smart.
Check that.
So,
listen,
the fact that we're
I appreciate
doing this
your interest
culture,
in my work.
It's subversive and oddly, I say feminist. I argue feminist.
We both have
a hard to focus with all these questions.
Not a problem. I'll just observe.
Like,
it's really something else.
I like hot fucking mom. I'll tell you this. Dude. I want my male mom
no way.
To be fucking hot.
Yeah.
I want to be
of
like,
course.
Oh wow, that guy's so much better than me. You know?
Of course.
I wish I could look like that guy. I don't want to look at a guy and be like, oh, you mean if I fucking fasted for a week I could look like this guy? I don't want that to be the model. I want it to be a guy that's way
better looking.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I love supermodels. I loved Chrissy Turlington and Cindy Crawford and all these people
up
that were just
right.
better than me. But I just accepted, like, oh, they're just way better than me in that department of life. Like, they're just prettier than me.
That is Ezra
Baird,
former Mossad interrogator. His services are in demand at the moment.
Everybody gets something. A lot of people...
Get?
I mean, I didn't get a body. I'll tell you that. I didn't get
that's
a body.
Not true. I love your body.
Yeah, that's love. That's different.
Let's take this guy with the fiber wire if I can.
What I'm saying is that...
Oh, he has to be leaving.
Like, you know,
that's right.
I'm able to...
Oh.
No, I'm just kidding. You're funny and you're handsome.
Ezra
you're
Berg has been eliminated.
Nice.
Good work.
You have a girthy penis. I don't like this movement to make everybody equal in terms of the looks department and stuff.
No. And that fucking
no
I can't fit anything else
you
in there.
Sports Illustrated did this year?
Hopefully nobody will find him by two, I guess.
They were just like, here's this pig, and here's this other kid chick that reads. And you're like, what the fuck? Used to be the hottest women on the planet. It was a jackpack. That's what it was. It was
yep.
like... There was 51 issues of Sports, and there once a year, Sports Illustrated was like, do you want to come? And they would send you the hottest sports shows alive in bikinis. And that was like, everybody was like, yes, this is a great thing. Now it's like, you know, this chick fucking is going to school, and she's a single mom, and you're like, who gives a fuck?
Well, especially because you're right, like, if... Okay, so let's maintain the integrity of the swimsuit edition and then start another magazine called Accomplished Women Nobody Wants to Fuck. And
yeah.
then there's that mag.
Yeah.
Instead of, like, don't ruin the brands that exist. I think Victoria's Secret wasn't doing very well, which is why they needed to rebrand.
That's
a stupid choice.
This is when
okay. Well, there's the fiber wire one.
They try to make not hot people desirable. Like, no. We all know who's hot. You don't get to tell us what's hot.
Drowning.
Yeah,
everybody agrees on what's hot.
There's an objective criterion. I think
of
it is unspoken.
Just because, like, greatness is objective. And hotness, like, perfect.
The
grunts
are here.
It's not like, well, the thing is, I really prefer a 380-pound chick. Well, you know what?
I don't think I've been seen by the camera yet, so I don't really feel like getting seen by that
go
camera,
yourself.
But.
It's not the hottest. It's not the hottest. There's a
not
reason
the biggest
we all
deal.
Go, like, oh, Beyonce. Beyonce is gorgeous.
Yeah.
Like,
so you're
no,
saying
that's
put her on the cover.
Yeah.
I'll pull that issue out and I'll just
it's a free
sweating
man.
like a black
it
man. Get all excited. You know?
White for free.
Hey, let's do two dumb sluts podcasts.
Okay.
Just two dumb sluts.
Wait, we gotta rebrand it. They're not gonna like it. We're gonna make this now.
I think we should.
I know. So the show is called Hotties.
Hotties the Potties. Hotties the Pod.
Yeah, Hotties the Pod.
Yeah, but it's H O.
No, I'm just right behind him.
It's H-A-W.
If I would have reacted quicker.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. Welcome to Hollis.
But there are shows, I mean, similar to that, and there's YouTube videos.
Help me, guys. I need some help here.
Yeah.
I should have known better. I figured he was getting ready to turn around, but I was hoping I could get him before he did.
Every guy thinks so well, but that's not. I'll stop.
But that's because the, you know, most people consuming podcasts are still.
Yeah,
dudes,
I'll just poke him in the butt with my pin syringe.
I thought we were doing it. Oh, I'm sorry. Are we doing it? Yeah, hold on. I know. Oh my god. I was like, okay, and literally, Tom, like, literally, I was like, I want to get my nails done. But literally, I was like, I want to finger myself too. I'm like,
why?
I can't finger myself.
I'm about to blow chunks.
Literally.
What's your favorite color to get for a manicure?
I like all the colors. What's your favorite color?
I hate when I get cum.
Wait, what was the other one I was trying to do?
Oh my god, I love it. You don't love cum? I forgot
now.
Oh, drowning.
I don't like
when
I
get you should be in the bathroom, man.
Oh
my god. Wait, we have to do this. This is what dumb girls always do. Like, oh my god, like, I don't like
when guys,
when
their balls smell,
like,
eh.
I kind of like it.
Sean Rose confirmed down. Nicely done.
I kind of like it when a guy's balls.
Kind of wish
I
could hide the body, but. Drag his body all the way through here in front of this guy. Oh, he's gonna sit down on that couch. So.
Oh.
There's another guy coming down that hallway, man. Yeah. Okay, well, there's the two challenges that I was trying to do.
And
I still have two targets left.
And I was all, yeah. And he's like, yeah.
Big dicks are good for pictures, but, like, in my mouth, I feel like
I'm not putting myself that one right yet.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my god. Oh, my god. Don't you love sucking dick? Oh, my god. It's, like, my favorite. Literally, it's like, I love it.
Okay, we gotta do a commercial.
Okay.
We'll be back hot as the pot.
They do a read as one of those shows.
No, they can't. They can't read.
I know, that's a problem.
We're gonna have to.
Do I have to do all four at once? That's what it seems like, because I've only done one this round. So, yeah, that one's. Can't do it now.
You 24/7. 5-on-5. It'll be a hit.
Oh, are you kidding me? Guys will be J-ing their D in droves.
I'm telling you.
Gas explosion.
I know. What? And it's so, because it's so true on the gram. I mean, you see who's popular there. Well, who's telling me that, like,
what's fascinating about the gram, though? There's a million.
That's weird.
I'm okay if I got two accomplishments, usually.
Right? Yeah. You can see.
Knock these last two people out somehow or another.
With 600 followers.
Hey, leave me alone, sir.
And then 1,000 posts, and she's like half naked.
Ah, shit.
And you scroll, and there's another girl half naked. She got 6.8 million followers.
Get in a hurry.
Like,
I can't see. My stupid sun is shining through the window.
What's going on? Like, why? I understand that all these people are trying to do the same thing.
Now I've been seen by the camera and spotted. Oh, well.
I don't really know.
Fuck it.
Someone told me
especially
that
especially when it's just in photos. You know what I mean? Like, we're talking about just... It's not like creating a podcast or... like more involved content. These are just photos.
Sir, you're not authorized to be here.
Well,
you speak the same language, sir.
Everybody on that cast.
I mean, is it that you know that person, so maybe kind of well known?
Yes, I think that's the thing. But I'm talking about, these are unknown people. Like, I read an article about how there are so many content creators on OnlyFans that for... Like, because people thought it was, like, basically a way to get free, like, you know, money just easy. And the vast majority of them are not hired. Like, it's a very, very small portion that earn a lot of money on that platform. Mm-hmm. But that's, here's the thing, you have to be creating videos, and it's, like, more involved is my point. With Instagram, we're literally just looking at photos.
Hello?
You're seeing, I'm not talking about a well-known model. This is like a nameless
just
person.
Photos.
You know. Yeah. Who's attractive, of course. But why does it work for some?
Why? I don't know. And also when you think about, like, I follow Madonna.
Yeah.
And she has professionally done photos on her website.
Come on,
every week,
give me a break.
Which means that she's doing
what?
Full hair and makeup and doing a photo shoot.
That's
like every week to create.
I'm not mad at that, though. Are you mad at that?
Just Instagram content. I'm not mad at that.
I've got a possible disturbance.
Can you imagine doing that every week, having like a full photo shoot just to post to the gram?
But
I respect
every superstar.
All right, fuck it.
I'm going to deliver some superstar shit to you. You know what I mean? She's fucking Madonna. So, hey, you want to come with
every
a pro
week.
Photo shoot every week? By the way, she's unrecognizable. Like, I don't...
I know. That's partially why I follow, is because I'm looking at her face.
That's
Madonna,
nice wording in Mozambique.
That's Madonna, and, like, what is happening there? And her boyfriend is, like, 24 years old.
Always. She has been fucking on the same age dick. She's been hopping on it for the last 40 years.
It's
impressive.
Kind of,
she's got to be in her 60s.
Oh, easily. And then her son Rocco is about
the same age
as
Jordan Cross's funeral, huh?
Which is really creeps out.
She looks unrecognizable.
She looks ghoulish.
How you doing?
Ghoulish.
Okay, I wasn't gonna go there.
Oh, it is terrifying.
Holy shit, soldier. You might want to step a little closer to the target to make sure you hit it.
I know.
You want to do it?
I'd love to.
Okay, I'll put a clip for you. You'll like this.
I'll wait for you,
okay.
Boy.
Okay.
Sir, I think that belongs...
We worked out this whole season.
I might just blow up.
Close to you.
I just feel like getting started with. I have stuff to do.
I
need to go
really
do something.
Okay.
Hello there.
Keep putting it off.
Then Andrew Gaze.
I'm curious. What's Eric's filtration plan?
Well, we've got it covered. Don't worry.
Don't worry.
Maya Parvati is down. Good work.
Well, I killed a non-target, but whatever.
Rise and shine. This time it's for real. Negative command, but nothing so far.
I really don't want to do that again, though. I think people have to be right on top of it.
Very charming.
Literally, I love smelly poop. Oh my god, when my boyfriend poops in my house, makes me so sick.
Alright, guys.
No,
I just came today to check on everything.
So this was an interview. Do you want to hear this interview?
I fucking loved it.
Here's the clip again.
We worked out this offseason, the whole time I was in Melbourne.
What's up, Greg?
We've been in the gym together for a long time. So,
wanted to make sure everything was running smoothly.
Hey,
so,
this isn't good.
No,
I don't think this is good at all.
Weird.
So the reporter...
Shit.
Oh my god, no way!
I'm so used to every Thursday.
The problem here
calls being auto-muted that I assume.
Take a deep breath, stay close to me. Are we clear?
I got it!
So I'm 99% sure Josh Judy just heard me ask, did you poop my old son and thinks I was talking to him?
I have nothing to report from my current location.
Oh, that is you.
We're in position. Everybody watch your six. I want no surprises. Okay.
Son, pull my shit. Spread out.
Did you poop? Did you poop? Open your
your pants.
And now there's a game.
Roof is clear. Moving on.
And you're like, are you? And he wants to be left alone, so he goes to another room. Then he comes back.
How are we
looking?
Are we clear?
And you're like, great.
All clear, sir.
Check, and there's no poop. And he's like,
come on, do you copy?
I'm at the location now.
Like 8 days in a row. And on the ninth day, you're like, stop fucking around.
Affirmative.
And then
you open
it.
Out.
And he's like, see? You're like, hey, dude, 1 of 9 is not cool.
He does it just
talk to me. What's our status? Are we green? All clear. Standing by.
Love avoiding sleep. It's so funny.
God.
Our oldest.
And it's all I want.
Now he is like, I mean, he pushes it to the degree where he's
okay,
like,
we're safe for now. Good job.
Like, what do you have to get?
Thanks.
Lift
don't let this happen again.
And he goes upstairs. He brings a handful of bullshit down. And then he gets in bed.
What?
And I'm like, all right. He's like, stay here. I'm like, what? He's like, stay here and talk to me. Okay, and then when I finally, I'm like, all right, and I get, he goes, no, stay longer. Well, I'm like, why? He's like,
what the?
I miss you. I'm like, shut the fuck. Don't miss
no,
me.
No, you don't.
Just been here all day.
No, and you know what they did to, they're doing to me now, because I know I love them, is they're like, mommy, I need another hug.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I need another hug. Yeah.
I need another hug. I love you so much, mommy. I'm like, oh, really? Yeah. Mommy, I'm hungry, and they know I'm not going to deprive them of food.
And Ellis, the other day, he goes,
man.
Can I give you a kiss good night? Yeah, buddy. I leaned down, he licked my eye. I was like, ugh. And he was like, I didn't want to kiss you. I was like, oh, man.
No, they're cute. I'm so stoked they're, you know, they're going to start kindergarten tomorrow.
You know what we got to start really paying attention to?
Excuse me?
Is their drug consumption. And
well, I just want to finish. Come
kids
on.
Kids are into drugs, and here's the thing. They're very clever.
Different.
Kids are different. And they're clever, and they start hiding drugs, and now...
Contact! Stay alert!
They're showing you
Graves is down.
Oh, they caught me? Motherfuckers.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Okay.
My name is Officer Jamie Donahue from the Falmouth Police Department, and today we are going to take a look at the hidden and plain sight mock bedroom setup. And we're going to start right over here on my left with...
Oh, you know, just, you know, wanted to make sure everything was running smoothly. So, the connection's secure? No weird signals or anything?
No weird signals, no. Connectivity's a bit of a problem, but we're rerouting some things. It all looks fine. Should we be on alert?
No. No, I just like making sure. Big ears out there, you know? You can, never be too careful.
Sure. We're on top of it. No need to worry.
Glad to hear it. If you encounter anything unusual, let me know immediately. Yeah?
Sure, Graves. We'll keep you in the loop. Ooh. Stern, drop something.
Huh?
What's that doing here? Biff, my friend.
Well, that's not super useful. Well, it could be, I guess. I just want to kill her.
Graves is down. Excellent work, 47.